Shown you the outside. Let me So here's all the makeup. This is very standard for Wet n Wild PR boxes. They all seem to come this way with each product individually placed in its little slot. And I will show you closer the makeup in one moment, but I wanted to show you the other side of the box because it's really cute. So you open it up and it says the same as the front of the box. And then inside here, let me move this over. You've got more of the characters and a little scene over here. They did a really nice job on this box. It's very, very pretty and super cute, I must say. As cute as a coffin can be, I suppose. Okay. So, let me put that back. Okay, so in this collection, you get a glitter body illuminator, a blush lighter palette, a sticky serum primer, stick, the eyeshadow palette, a white and green metallic liquid liner, a tubing mascara, three blush and lip combos. I'll probably just use them as blush, to be honest. So, I was gonna leave the box out and then pull each item, but I think it will be too loud when I do that. So, just like my Friday the 13th collection, I'm going to show you each item individually. And then I will do swatches and all that fun stuff. So, let me readjust everything and we will deep dive into this adorable collection. So, the first product we're going to take a closer look at is the Glitter Body Illuminator. And this has a gorgeous purple iridescent shift in it with other multicolored glitter. I'm hoping you'll be able to see that, but it is absolutely gorgeous. And this is a glass bottle with a little dropper applicator. Also, again, please ignore the redness on my fingers. It's from doing nails. I swear my hands will never look normal again. But it's fine. Let's swatch this, shall we? You can definitely see that shift in the light there. Gorgeous. Okay. I just need a teeny tiny bit. I'm going to swatch it on my non-dominant. Leaves a very pretty shimmer. It might be hard to see on chest, arms, wherever. And it does smell like pumpkin spice, which is awesome. All of these products are available individually, by the way, unless they've sold out. So that is the first product in the box. Okay, I went ahead and turned the purple lighting down even further because I really don't want any of these swatches to get altered by the light. So, moving right along, we have the Sticky Serum Primer. And I would assume this is similar to the e.l.f. Sticky Primers, like the Jelly Pop, which is my personal favorite, and the green one that they have. I can't remember what it's called, but that's what I assume this will be like. It's an A-tube style packaging with a pump. I'm not gonna swatch this because it's just a primer, but I will be trying all of these products out in a testing new makeup video, so we will check it out then. But we got Oogie Boogie on there. Again, the packaging is just so cute on this collection. They did such a good job. They always do, though. Wet n Wild really does their special collections well. This also has 5% niacinamide, by the way, which is a great skincare ingredient. Niacinamide helps with skin's texture as well as reducing the appearance of dark spots. So that's the primer. The blush lighter palette, which has three different shades in it, a golden highlight, a coral blush, and a lavender blush, which I'm very excited about. Oh my god, I hate how red my fingers are. I'm so sorry. I should probably go with my other hand. Sally on here, and you can see the colors behind her. Very cute. And by the way, Wet n Wild is a vegan and cruelty-free brand. If that is something that's important to you. Okay, let me open this. I have to cut the plastic. One moment. Everything is so hard to get out of the packaging. But that's a good thing, because then you know it comes sealed and well taken care of in the shipping process. Okay, here is the pan with our gorgeous shades in there. So let's get to swatching. I'm gonna do each one individually. So we have lavender, this coral, and then the golden highlight. They look very pigmented and super pretty. Those are so pretty. I'm a huge fan of lavender. I have green eyes, so lavender looks really nice with them, especially when I do a blush eye combo. And I lean more on the cool end of the spectrum, so these kinds of shades look really nice against my complexion, so super excited about that. This is a gorgeous coral, and as you can see, they both have like a sheen to them, which is really nice. And then the golden highlight, which would definitely be too dark for me as a highlighter, but I would so pretty. I can definitely use this in Christmas looks as well. It is super, super liquidy. So I'll just have to be careful, but how gorgeous is that green? Oh my gosh, I'm so excited, you guys. Had some nice sounds on these. I will absolutely be dusting these out in that video coming up, so those are the liners. The next product is this tubing mascara. Now, I'm extremely picky when it comes to mascara, so this will definitely be put to the test. If it's not that good, it can be used as a base before I put falsies on, because I don't care about that as much. But if I'm just curling my natural lashes and wearing them as is with mascara, I'm so picky. I have very long lashes, but they're straight, so it has to hold a curl, which is why I only use waterproof. So we'll see how this goes. So this is actually really funny because I can't open this. It is on so tight, and I had put lotion on my hands before filming this that I quite literally can't open it. So I'm going to have to insert a clip of me showing you what the wand looks like, because this thing is not budging right now, not with all the lotion on my hands. I even tried using my shirt to get some, like, traction on it, but it's just not, it's not opening. But after I'm done, I will insert a clip. Okay, that's the tubing mascara. Honestly, it's probably a good thing that it's on so tight, because then you know the product won't be dried out, so that is a plus, I will say. Obviously, I'm going to save the eyeshadow palette for last, so I just have a few more products to show you, and one of which are these cheek and lip duo products, but usually when something's for both the cheek and the lips, I tend to just use them on the cheeks because the formula's more creamy. But just know these are marketed as a dual product. I'm most excited about these because I love cream blush products and the colors are stunning. So I can't wait to try these, but let's take a closer look at each one individually and swatch it. So the first shade is called On Lockdown, and it's this really gorgeous burnt orange color, which will be great for fall makeup looks. These I can't open, so that's fabulous. See, just based off of this alone, the way that came out, I would only use these on my cheeks. We have a nice doe foot applicator on there. There's a pretty good chunk of product, so I'll just swatch all of it. Yeah, these are definitely gonna be better for a cheek product. But that shade is beautiful. That would look so nice with like a monochromatic makeup look with like a burnt orange eye. I really like that. Again, this was On Lockdown. Okay, next we have Barrel of Scares, which is this gorgeous deep eggplant purple shade. on the cheeks, and I'm sure they're gonna blend out really nice just based on the consistency of the product. So that is Barrel of Scares. Yeah. $5 in that first column. Okay. Oh my gosh, that swatched so nice. That'll be a great transition shade. Beautiful icy blue. That'll be great for winter looks. ISO on my camera so you can get a better look at the colors, because I felt like my ISO was slightly high and was washing them out. There's the first four. This like multicolored glitter will be so pretty as a topper. Okay, let's go into the next column. Again, another breast glitter right here with this gold. Absolutely swatched so nice. I love how unique the color story is. It's not something overdone that we've seen a million times. And I'm going to have a lot of fun coming up with a look for this palette. All right, you guys, so that is everything that comes in the